Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Flowers, the Volumes of Pretense. Last time, we were about to take the media test.
What will the results be? Let's find out.
Take your time to answer. Don't rush, says Sister Basquiat to Rika, who asks how much time we have.
皆さんの鉛筆が止まりましたら終わりにしますから。
She says,
急がないわけないじゃない。
I face my question page, feeling rushed and pressured by the sounds of pencils scribbling on paper. What she really means is that the person who takes the longest will make everyone else wait.
急がなくちゃとは思うけれど。
The test is looking intense. The test, spanning 150 questions, has many questions asking us, the students, about ourselves. If I tried to answer them on the spot, I could probably answer them just fine, but... When I was a child, I would always follow orders without complaint. Agreed. If I answer without thinking things through, I might be paired with someone I wouldn't want to be paired with. I could get matched with a media partner I'm incompatible with. It would be awful indeed. I mean, you ain't want to be friends with someone you don't get along with, right? I like to daydream. Agree. I want to rush, but I can't. Still agonizing over it, I force myself to choose an answer. I do not care about manners. Agree. Wasn't I told my manners were good? I think that as I move my pencil. It doesn't matter what you feel about yourself if others do not value you. I think about or have tried dressing as the opposite sex. Well, to be honest, some of my clothes are boys' clothes. At least they're meant to be boys' clothes. So I'm gonna be honest with myself here when I say agree. I fill in the answer sheet while puzzling over what the strange question it is. I have received neurological or psychiatric treatment. Agree. It's an embarrassing question, but I suppose it is important if we're all going to live together. I have had a strange feeling that I was not myself.
When do you ever feel like you're yourself?
The moment I move my pencil, all of a sudden, I feel a pain deep within my chest. It is a strange feeling, a painful and terrifying feeling.
Could that feeling be amor?
But... Rubbing my furrowed brow with pencil, I turn to the rest of the test questions. We've got nothing else to agree with? I have finished answering the long questions and have come to the last one. What kind of friend would you like? After finishing writing my answer, I finally take a breather and sneak over in the class. I had written my answers in a hurry since being last class would be embarrassing, but now it seems I finished early. Now I kind of wonder who's going to finish last. I can still hear the sound of pencils running across paper. If that is the case, maybe I should write a bit more. The final question. For the question of what kind of friend would you like, I had specified in detail this and that about personality, but... This is someone I'm going to be spending the next 3 years with. Every detail is important. As I'm trying to take the paper in one hand, I drop my answer sheet and hurriedly begin to pick it up. As I do,
どうぞ.
Mayuri! Mayuri picks my test up from the floor and hands it to me.
Shirahane-san?
My face. No, my entire body instantly becomes hot. Why is she the one next to me? How? Questions swirling in my head. I wonder if she moves to get closer to a certain someone. Eh, who knows? I had gotten up to go to the restroom once, and when I came back to my seat, well...
Ichigo-san-janai.
The back in front of me was not her petite form, but a different person's back. Had there been a break when I went to the bathroom? When I come back, everyone was waiting for the test, and so I rushed back to my seat, but...
Shirahane-san, kore.
Finally comprehending that Mayuri is really is sitting next to me, I take the test she is handing me with shaking hands. I think as I glance the test on Mayuri's desk. Makes me wonder. No, I think it's just that Mayuri hasn't written anything. Hearing Mayuri's treble voice, I look to her and see she is looking at the sentence writing on my test. Seething with shame, I... I think I'm gonna ask her for what kind of friend she wrote about wanting. I ask. I've gone and asked it. Of course, her eyebrows knit together at this, and I turn white as a sheet, wondering why I had asked such a stupid question. She points to the last answer I wrote, which is multiple lines.
こんなに真面目に書いている人に聞かせるのが恥ずかしいかなって思って。
There's a lot left to be done. There's a lot left to be done here. She says with a wry grin as she puts the test back on my desk.
こんなにたくさん書いて、その、うん、優しい人がいいとか、人当たりがいいだとか。当たり前のことばかり書いてないで、もう少しちゃんと考えてみるよ。ありがとうね、白羽さん。
You're welcome. She smiles kindly at me, and the only thing I can say is, okay. I thought I had embarrassed Mayuri, but she seems happy. Yay, she seems happy! I pretend to proofread my test, burying my face in the answer sheet so as to hide my embarrassment.I wonder if we'll be asked what kind of person we want to be paired with. Having heard there would be a final interview to determine our immediate partners, I'm sitting in one of the chairs lined up in the hallway, waiting for my turn. The words Ichigo had said as she went to her interview before me came to my lips, and I ruminate over them in my mind. Mayuri, who had picked up my test for me, comes to mind.No. I would be happy to have Rika, the class president and most studious person in the class, as my immediate partner. I choose... Eeny, meeny, miny, Mayuri. I remember her smiling kindly at me. On the cherry blossoms in the dark of the night, she smiled at me.Mitsuo Shirahane! Called upon by Sister Basquiat.
That was a really bad voice I did for her.
I get to my feet. Why don't we go together this time, she says. As I am As I am resting limply in the hallway after the nerve-wracking interview, Rika speaks to me. I am tired, and when she makes the offer again, I simply accept. We head outside the school building to where the upperclassmen await us.
Wow, it's so beautiful!
It's really nice. Rika says, looking up at the high ceiling of the entrance. A rainbow of colors pours through the beautifully crafted stained glass in the ceiling. I nod to myself, thinking about how the wide entrance, which we've had no time to look at it while rushing to class, really is beautiful. I mean, when you've been around one culture for so long, when you've been around the style of one culture for so long, it's nice to see the style of another. Perhaps question marks have appeared around my head at the word dormitory, because Rika smiles and explains.
寄宿舎のことをドミトリーって言うのよ。ミッションスクールに入学するのだから調べておいたの。
The housing of schools be called dormitories? I can't help but smile at Rika, who is proudly puffing out her chest.
やっぱり子供っぽいと思うわよね。大人な白羽さんに話したのは失敗だったかしら。ごめん。嘘、冗談よ。やっと笑ってくれたからつい嬉しくなっちゃって。昨日は勇気を出して話しかけたのに逃げられちゃったから気にしていたの。何か失礼なことをしたんじゃないのかって。そんなこと。
You didn't know.
That's just
shyness.
でも、どうして走って行っちゃったの？私、それが気になって。
Rika fills with the handrail the old stairs as she asks me, and I... You know what? We're gonna be honest with Rika right now. We're gonna be completely honest. Confess the truth. Be honest. I don't know why I think this, but I start speaking to Rika, who seems anxious.
実は、私、とある理由で学校に通っていなかったの。そうなの？
Really?
自宅内学習という制度で勉強はしていたのだけど、それで話しかけられた時。どうしていいかわからなくなって。
I see. Rika mutters the words, nodding to herself, and looks down, a grave expression on her face. I regret ever saying anything.
よかった。
What?
あ、白羽さんをバカにしたのではなくて、嫌われたのじゃなくて、よかったって思ったの。暗がりで急に呼びかけたのだから失礼だったって思ったし、そんなこと、だからよかったって。白羽さんは学校に通っていなかったことを気にしているようだけど大丈夫よ。この学院にはアミティエ制度もあるし、クラスメートみんないい子ばかりだったじゃない。だからすぐに仲良くなれるわ。
Will I really? Yes, you will.
今もこうして仲良くおしゃべりしているしね。
I nod slightly, encouraged by her kind, friendly smile. She then holds her hand out to me.
それじゃ、行きましょう。
She says.
これからどうしようかな。
Whoa! this scenery! This freaking scenery! This is beautiful! This is beautiful scenery! Beautiful! Beautiful! Beautiful scenery! Beautiful! Moving on. What should we do now? Looking up at the destroyed school building, I let out a long sigh. Back then. Having solved our misunderstanding, Rika holds out her hand, which was holding the number card given at the end of the interview we just had. She tells me that we should hurry up since the upperclassmen who are going to give us a tour of the campus were waiting. I part ways with her to find the upperclassmen with the same number on her chest as I have on my card, but... The upperclassman who's waiting for me, she seems popular, standing in the center of a group of students and laughing with them. First of all, I can't do this right now. I do not have the courage to interrupt when they are having such a good time talking. I had waited for them to finish their conversation, but it seemed the upperclassman started getting angry when the freshman, me, didn't show up. Then just go to them! It's only natural since they've been waiting a long time, but the more time passes, the less I'm able to go over, so I stand rooted to my spot. Well, I can understand that feeling, but... I see the name of the mystery novel I read as a child and wonder what to do next. But the time we're supposed to be back is... an hour and a half from now. I don't want to be there by myself. I start walking back to the school building with heavy feet in an attempt to kill time. I must have been wandering around for about a half hour when... All of a sudden, Shiroi-san! A voice calls out and I turn around. Seeing a familiar face coming towards me from down the hall, I'm at once filled with joy and an urge to hide. I wave weakly to her as she comes trying down the hallway, and Rika hurries over to me with a smile. Rika returns! The tour didn't end early. There was no tour at all. If she says I finished early, wouldn't that mean she did too? She seems to have read my question through my silence as we could clasp her hands together and explain.
She
says that brightly. She cocks her head at me as if to ask, what about you? I consider telling her that my guide also had an emergency and had to leave early, but... I don't want to hurt her again like last night. You guys are the truth, right?
こっちよ、こっち! あ、花火師さん?
Ooh, a ballet room! Rika pulls me by the hand to the corner classroom. She shows me the impressive mirrored room, and all I can do is say, oh, in a squeaky voice.
あら、どうしたの?
I confess that I was unable to approach the upperclassmen and wander about the campus aimlessly. Rika didn't mock me, nor did she laugh at me.
なら、私が案内するわ。
She offered, and my eyes nearly welled up with tears of joy. The problem for me now, at this moment, is that my hand is being held.
しかして急ぎすぎて疲れちゃった？
Ah, I see the way. I see how they did that.
いえ、そうじゃないわ。そう、私、嬉しくなるとつい夢中になっちゃう癖があって、早足になってたのかなって思ったから、行き過ぎたところがあったら気にせずに行ってね。
She looks up at me. She looks up at me with kind eyes from behind her glasses, and I start to sweat. Maybe this is a normal thing between girls, but this is the first time a person the same age and sex as me has held my hand. I'm sweating, and it's all I can do to keep myself from blushing furiously.
Shirahane-san, wa ballet wo yatta koto ga aru no? Ie, yatta koto nai desu.
Well, judging from the fact that she mentioned herself in a leotard and got embarrassed about it, she definitely hasn't.
So, style もいいし、立ち振る舞いも背筋に芯が通っているように見えたから、もしかしたらと思っていたのだけど、違うのね。
I returned the flattery with a forced smile. She's been holding my hand ever since she started giving me this tour. The more I try not to be nervous, the more my palms sweat.Don't worry about it! Since she is holding my hand, she is close enough for me to feel her breath. She's shorter than me, and there's a nice, soft, sweet smell coming from around the collar of her uniform. The femininity of it sends my temperature rising ever higher.
学校でバレエを習うなんて不思議な気持ちだわ。クラスメートにレオタード姿を見られるわけだし。
I look into her carefree smile. My mind wanders as I think about how lovely her long eyelashes are behind her glasses.
ちょっと恥ずかしいわよね、白羽さん。
I can't speak properly, and I look down as I feel my cheeks get hot.
日がよく当たるように作られてるのね。少し暑いわ。次はもう少し涼しげなところに行きましょう。
I wonder if she's already noticed my red face.
お願いします。
お願いします。That's all I can manage, aware of her soft hand still holding mine. Next place she leads me to is... It's the library!A library which is so magnificent that I let out a cry as I stare at it in wonder. So many books!
なかなかの蔵書よね。すごい。
She's in Wonderland! Rika's in the book Wonderland!There's a slightly moldy smell unique to old books, and dim lighting to protect the books from damage is calming. The wooden bookshelves, rough yet stately. This is my dream library. Well, your dream has come true. Pinch yourself all you want, but it's not a dream!Further into the library as though beckoned by an invisible force, and struck a finger down the spines of the books on a nearby shelf. I've seen stately libraries like this in the movies, and it had always been my dream to go to one. Then,
ここなら涼しいからいいかなって思ったのだけど。別の意味でよかったみたいね。
I turn around as if awakening from a dream. Rika is giving me a look like I'm a child who has just found a toy.
つい夢中になって。いいの。図書室を案内して正解みたいね。ここ、なんていうか映画のセットみたいよね。私もそう思ったわ。 でしょ。でも案内してくれた上級生の話だとあんまり人気のない施設みたい。今時の本は置いてなくて古書ばかりらしいから。そうなんだ。
I stare at the book I have been stroking. The sun-faded, yellowing spine somehow seems lonely.
お昼と放課後は解放されているそうだからまた来ましょう。
She urges me onto the next place, and I feel reluctant to leave. However, Suo, I bet you're gonna be here a lot. Right now, just those words are music to my ears.
それじゃ次は私のお気に入りの場所を案内するわね。次の場所へ行きましょう、白羽さん。
She holds out her hand to me, and I at last realize I had let go of it.Her favorite places.
調理室?
There we go, like, In contrast to the rooms we've seen up until now, which feels somewhat historic, this room has modern appliances installed in it. A simple tiled sink, two gas cookers side by side, and tableware arranged neatly in clean cabinets. Rika steps forward and spreads her arms out amidst the kitchen counters.
すごいでしょ。
She exclaims.
ここってクラブハウスが並んでいる場所よね。なら、そう、ここもクラブの一つ、料理クラブよ。
The cooking club, huh? Octodons, anyone? Nah, just kidding. At the school, they're probably not gonna make any octodogs.But there is another game I'm thinking about that has a, that takes place in a school that has a cooking club. In a cooking club. If anyone has been around my channel, anyone who has been around my channel long enough will know exactly what game I'm talking about. But I digress. It's certainly not the kind of place where they should make all the students' food. Rather, the small kitchen stations lined up together look like.Make the cooking schools I've seen in movies. So it makes more sense that it would be the cooking club.
こんなに立派な設備があるなんて。すごいわよね。これで正式な部ではないって言うんだから、驚く。正式な部じゃない?それじゃあこれって、同好会なの?ううん。同好会とは少し違うの。予算は出ているそうだし。
If that's the case, how is it different from an official club?
学院で公認されている正式な部は合唱部、文芸部、天文部の3つだけなんですって。
Only three clubs? That's kind of unfair, to be honest.
でも、他の生徒が学びたいって自発的に人を集めてクラブにしたものが手芸クラブや美術クラブ、それにこの料理クラブなんですって。
I take her words in as I look around. It looks too professional to say that students started all by themselves.
さすがはお嬢様学校よね。
I tell Rika, who is triumphantly puffing at her chest, that I would be really excited if I like cooking.
え?私別に料理が得意だとか好きだとかじゃないわよ。
Then why is this her favorite place?She says she brought me here because she said she brought me here because this is her favorite place. Seeing my expression, not unlike a deer in headlights, she smiles and waves her hand.
私が気に入ったのはこっち。
She walks away from the counters to the wall where there's a shelf of cooking utensils. I follow her.
どう?品が良いものばかり揃えていると思わない?良いものって。
Dishes, forks, whips, tongs, and other utensils are arranged on the shelf like decorations. Ah! She likes the decorations, huh?
確かに高そうではあるけれど。
I'm not exactly an expert on cutlery, but if the gleaming knives and forks look like they're made of silver, they are expensive.
そうでしょう。上級生に案内されていた時にはじっくり見られなかったから、もう一度見に来たかったの。そうなんだ。
Different strokes for different folks, but silverware? I marvel that someone could be interested in this.
こういうのはデザインだとか、使っている材質だとかで、しあしがあるのかな。
Must be.
やっぱりだわ。ちらっと見たとき、そうだとは思ったけれど、まさかこんなに珍しい品が置いてあるなんて。私も手に入れるのが大変だったのに。やっぱりこういうのって専門店で買われるの？ええ、自分で比べてみて取り寄せるの。やっぱり品質が違うわ。匂いでわかるもの。
The smell?Do high-quality materials smell better? I've never smelled silverware before. I don't think anyone has smelled silverware before, except for Rika, maybe. But stainless steel forks and silver forks probably smell different.
ねえ、白羽さんなら、この中でどれがお好み？どれが？
I'm not particularly attached to eating utensils. to eating utensils.
銀製のものを試してみたいかも。銀？
She cocks her head as she gives me an instantly blank look, and I become embarrassed, thinking my choice in silverware was unrefined. But after a moment, Rika claps her hands together.
ああ、シルバーで銘が書かれている缶のことね。ウバを選ぶなんて白羽さんも通なのね。
ウバ？No, she said tin just now.
ダージリンやアッサムみたいな王道を選んでいるのではないものね。ウバを選ぶところを見るとミルクティーが好みなのかしら。でももったいないのよね。ウバは綺麗な紅色なのにミルクを垂らしてしまうから。ダージリン。
I say, and finally, I at last noticed square tins lined up on top of the top shelf above the silverware, and understand that she had been talking about tea the whole time.
Ah! That makes sense!
食器マニアじゃなかったんだ。マニア。そうね。そう言われるのは少し嬉しいかも。
Rika gives a satisfied smile. I, on the other hand, turn red at the fact that I've been so confused.
でも、さすがミッションスクールよね。専門店以外でこんなに種類が揃っているのを初めて見たわ。やっぱりお茶会とかあるのかしら。そうね、あるのかも。
I still haven't recovered from my mistake. Rika gazes at the cased up tins with twinkling eyes, then claps her hands together.
そうだ、同じクラスになった記念に。クラスみんなを誘ってお茶会を開いたらどうかしら。家から茶葉をたくさん持ち込んだから簡単な催しならできると思うし。お茶会か。
Scenes from the novel Anne of Green Gables or the movie Marie Antoinette come to mind. I've always longed to be surrounded by friends in a tea party. You could even call it a dream.
いいかも。でしょ？いいアイディアだわ。
I'm lost in my daydreams when I hear a voice right by my ear and I quickly look up.
Shirahane-san. お誘いしたら、Shirahane-san も参加してくれる？
She squeezes my hand once again and...
ダメ？
Aww! Poor Rika, she looks so sad! Heat rises to my neck and I feel...It continues towards my face. Rika's hand wrapped around mine. Just the realization makes me start to sweat all over again.
今度こそちゃんと伝えるのよ。 私でよければ。本当？よかった。楽しいお茶会になりそうね。
It'll be fun indeed. I somehow managed to smile in response to her excited words. This is what I lack, I think, as I watch her bounce a little. If I acted more like Rika, then I would have friends too. I look up to the ceiling instinctively at the distant yet clear sound of the bell ringing. I feel the excitement that had been building inside me go cold, and a different kind of excitement now grips me deep within my heart.
急ぎましょう、白羽さん。
She holds out her hand.
はい。
Pulling back my embarrassment, I gently take her hand. Who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be? Hearing a poem, a sense of deja vu comes over me. The freshman class is awaiting the results of the immediate selection with a single cup off to break the silence, just like at the entrance ceremony. While waiting for the announcement, I get the feeling that this is not the first time I have felt this way.
いつのことだろう?
Filled with a jumbled mix of emotions that could be the expectation or fear, I fumble for what lies ahead beyond the sense of deja vu that's telling me I have experienced it before.
この学院に来る前の、少し前の記憶。
My life at my old school that I just couldn't adapt to.
違う。もっと前。
The day I was put in my grandfather's care.
あの時感じたのは、安堵だ。
Mother's death.
違う。私があの時受けた感情は別物だ。母が亡くなった日は今の私が私になった日だ。
Oh. I'm sorry. My mother died, and so it was just me and my father. Although our life was lonely, my father was kind, and I wanted for nothing. I had been grateful. However,
父は私が耐えられぬほど寂しいのだと勘違いしていた。
Of course, I did miss my mother.
父は無口になった私をおもんぱかっていた。
After my mother's death, I became antisocial. But it wasn't out of loneliness. My mother was talkative, and because I would engage her in conversation, he thought I was talkative too.After her death, I simply reverted to my original temperament. He remarried. I remember my stepmother's face, and I realized the deja vu I'm feeling from across. And I realized the deja vu I'm feeling comes from the first time I met that woman. Feeling as though I have held my new star at the academy, and the Amitya with whom I'll learn and grow.I squeeze my eyes shut and banish those visions of my family. It is better to be optimistic. Your stepmother must have not been a good person. The feeling of expectation and fear comes naturally with meeting new people, I think as I shake my head. Then I hear the sound of footsteps ascending to the podium. I look up nervously and before my eyes,I think it is called a gazebo. A word meaning a small building in the garden used for resting. So the term is technically correct, but it is in the same Western style as the campus, lecture hall, dormitories, and its appearance makes me hesitate to call it a gazebo. It is just like something out of the movie Marie Antoinette. Seeing it,Standing there, proudly among seasonal roses of all colors in bloom is overwhelming. No, there's another reason I feel overwhelmed.
Wow,
it's Ichigo Ryo!
At
the sitting at the table, the Sasaki twins were chattering away boisterously. Then...
My ear really got... ただ、グラニュー糖とクリームの配分がもう少しうまくやれれば、生クリームがもっと美味しくなったのにな。へえ、高坂さん、お料理詳しいの？お菓子作りは趣味でね。ケーキ類は昔散々作ったものさ。
Please tell me she's gonna be in the cooking club. Please tell me she's gonna be in the cooking club. Please tell me she's gonna be in the cooking club.
意外だわ。あんまりお料理が作れる人だと思わなかったのに。
What is that supposed to mean? My ear acts slightly scary look in your eyes.
お茶のおかわりはどう？白羽さんはミルクティーがお好みなのよね。
Ignoring Mayuri's question, Rika gets up to fix me some tea without waiting for my answer. I feel out of place. The other reason I feel overwhelmed is that we are having this tea party in this magnificent gazebo with all 20 of her classmates. At first I've been delighted, thinking that a tea party might be the optimal way to make friends, but...I am literally overwhelmed and unable to talk to anyone. I was drawn to myself, into myself. Rika, who said she likes both brewing and drinking tea, is calmly filling her classmates' cups whenever she spots one that's empty. Now it's my turn.
さあ、どうぞ。
She takes a teapot, which I've been keeping warm on the tea mat, and pours tea into my empty cup, then follows with warm milk.
ありがとう。いえ、冷めないうちにどうぞ。
I do as she says and take a drink. Fragrant and bitter, it's clearly different from store-bought tea.
おいしい。
The words spill from my lips as I do a double take.
それはね。ウバの茶葉なの。バラの香りがするでしょ。ここで飲むならこれだって思ったの。そうなんだ。セイロンティーの中では一番渋みと酸味が強いのが特徴なの。刺激的で深い苦味が最高なのよ。独特の後期はウバフレーバーといって、一度ストレートで飲んでみてほしいわ。
Oh really?I keep saying the same thing even when I've been given it in.
Ah, ごめんね。白羽さんはミルクティーが好きだって言っていたのに、好みまでいろいろ言われたくないよね。そんな。
She asked me, someone with no knowledge of tea, what kind of tea I liked, and without thinking, I said milk tea. That's all. I would drink whatever Rika recommends.Perhaps she heard me whispering because she had leaned in closer and is clucking her head. It almost feels as though she is touching my skin through my thin uniform, and I recoil in surprise. So, Rika is the Amitya partner?
委員長、リンゴのお茶がなくなったから入れてほしいって。アップルティーが欲しい。わかったわ。すぐ用意するわね。ねえ、私的にはジャンピングっていうのが見てみたいな。
Rika looks a bit confused.
あれは茶葉が跳ねるように沸き立たせることを言うのだけど、多分いちごさんはこっちのことを言っているのよね。
She swiftly changes the tea leaves and pours boiling water into the pot.Like Ringo, I'm surprised to see a scene from a movie come to life before my eyes, and I end up staring at Rika as she pours the tea with a look of concentration on her face.
本当はカップじゃなくてポットの方へお湯を入れるとき、茶葉を上下運動させるために勢いよく湯を入れることをジャンピングっていうの。
そうだったのですか。
これは空気をより含ませた方が美味しいから、そのための入れ方なのよ。 ねえねえ、今度は私のをやって。仕方ないわね。
She says, but does not seem to really mind as she pours tea into Ichigo's cup.
話す機会なさそうだね。
Mayuri says, stabbing at her cake with a fork, with a small sigh, I nod.
せっかくアミティエ同士になったのだから、ゆっくり話したいところだよね。
Speaking of which, I wonder what Mayuri's アミティエ put in. Is...It was decided that I would be Amitya partners with the class president Rika Hanabishi. It seems I had completely spaced out when I heard Rika's name. I finally snapped out of it when Mayuri, who was sitting in front of me, shook me.
ぎょっとしていたけど、花火師さんがアミティエになったのが嫌だった？
そんなことありません。ただ、予想外の名前だったので。
I thought the person listening to me so attentively right now, Mayuri, would be a good partner.
嫌なことはありません。今も、ああやってみんなに気を使える、いい人だって分かっているし。
確かに。紅茶好きだとは聞いたけど、根っから人をもてなすのが好きなんだろうね。放課後お茶会を開こうなんて考え、思いもつかなかったよ。
As Mayuri says this, I look Rika's way. She looks confused at having been offered a cake as thanks for showing her technique. Seeing her blushing and looking embarrassed as she puts its forkful cake in her mouth, I think how kind and thoughtful a person she is.
えー、普段飲むのよりもリンゴの香りがする。アップルティーってちゃんと専用の茶葉があるんだね。きちんと大別として認められているものだから、フレーバーを茶葉になじませてあるのよ。そうなんだ。また飲みたいな。ねえ、市販のティーパックでもアップルのやつって売ってるかな？
大丈夫。
ストレートしかない場合でもリンゴを薄くスライスして二切れほどカップに入れて注げばいいの。それで香りはつくわ。リンゴスライス。痛そう。あ、それじゃあイチゴの茶葉は？ストロベリー味とかないの？それは。
The pleasant banter of the Sasaki twins. Seeing Rika mingling and talking with the other classmates, I think about what will happen from now.It's probably not impossible to get closer with her, even as she takes care of all our classmates. But we probably won't have much time together as a media partners, will we? I stay and look toward her. It seems our conversation has finished and she turns to me.
あら、Kousaka-san, カップが空ね。おかわりはいかがかしら？
She's talking to Mayuri, not me.
いや、だいぶいただいたしね。ああ、そうだ。
何
でも言って。好みの紅茶を入れるから。
よし、それじゃあコーヒーをもらえるかな。ブラックで。
コーヒー isn't tea。
コーヒーですって。
But I watched the two of them pretending to be mad as they enjoyed their conversation。
寄宿舎では。
I make up my mind to talk to my immediate partner at the dormitory, where it will be just the two of us. Hope is a good thing, maybe the best of things, and no good thing ever dies. A quote from the Shawshank Redemption, a movie which has influenced me. In these circumstances, I am compelled to agree with those words.After the nerve-wracking tea party, I part ways with everyone and return to the dormitory. Not too shabby. I relax in the room that I will share with Rika Hanabishi, my Amitya partner. Then, just as I had hoped, I have an Amitya-like conversation with Rika in our room. We talk about all sorts of things, like our hobbies and hometowns.
私にしては、つまらずに話せたのだから。
大成功だわ。
Woo! I am elated that I can hold a casual conversation with a friend, even if she is just a friend by circumstance. So much so that the words from Shawshank Redemption come to mind. That's right, I could recall...
Shirahane-san, もう片付けが済んだの?
Not yet, I squeak.
荷物の整理が済んだら、ダイニングルームへ集まるよう言われているのだから、手早く済ませた方がいいわ。そうね。
The words catch my throat. I go to take my things from my bag. I feel my cheeks flush as I watch her neatly fold her underwear on the bed before putting away on the shelf.
女同士だから気にしないものなの?
Perhaps because we are the same sex, she folds her panties without any sign of embarrassment. Seeing this makes me blush.
私服とかはどこに置けばいいのかな? え?学院では制服以外は禁止だって規則に書かれていたでしょ?そうだったっけ?
Even though I'd been able to talk just moments ago, I cannot respond probably now. Perhaps Rika has noticed that I am being weary because she stops what she is doing and comes over.
どうしたの? 何か困ったことがあるなら言ってね。これから共同生活をする仲間なんだから。仲間。そうよ。アミティエなんだから気兼ねなく話してほしいわ。
She looks up at me with a gentle smile.
そうだわ。これから一緒に生活するのだから、これくらいで照れていてはダメよね。
Go for it. I've made up my mind.
共同生活なんだから、着替えとかだって。お着替え?ダイニングホールに集まって、みんなでお食事だって言われていたけど、お食事の前に着替えるの?え、いえ。
Afraid I might have shown my true colors, I feel my neck get hot again and I go silent. She cocks her head and looks at me in confusion.
おや、ノックをして入った方が良かったかな。それはそうでしょう。共同生活なのよ。親しき中にも礼儀ありでしょ。
My Yuri has invaded. My Yuri stands before the open door, looking at us like a child who has found a toy.
そういうまともな返しをするなんて、委員長はなかなかに肝が据わっているんだね。隔絶された女の園だよ。噂されるような状況は作らない方がいいな。
何を言って。
She points to the bed with the folded underwear and then to her own hand. Rika, who has just realized she is still folding her panties, is clearly dismayed as not just her cheeks, but her entire face turns crimson.
やっと気づいたようだね。旗から見れば下着を握りしめて白羽さんに迫っているみたいだよ。
違う。私は何か白羽さんが困っているようだったから。
おお。And you tried to figure it out while holding your panties, huh?
本当かい?
There's laughter in my Yuri's eyes, and Rika looks at me with a serious face.
うん、本当よ。
I nod my confirmation. Hearing me agree, Rika lets out a sigh of relief.
なんだ、誤解なのか。同室の相手が変わった趣味の持ち主だなんて、少し面白そうだと思ったんだけどね。
何を言っているのよ、もう。
冗談だよ。まあ、女同士だからって、あんまり大っぴらにしない方がいいってことさ。
Right? She asks, smiling at me. I reply with a yes. Hearing that it was a joke, Rika starts to open her mouth, but she takes a glance at the panties still in her hand and hurries back to the bed.
早く荷物の整理をした方がいいわ。もうすぐ食事よ。
階段の突き当たりでばったり佐々木、あれは姉かな。彼女と会ったのさ。 随分と話好きでなかなか解放してくれなかったんだよ。
そう。
Her curt answer somehow feels off. It feels somehow off.
整理した方がいい？いえ、それよりも。
I look at the cheery Mayuri.
さっき、同室の相手がって言ったような。
I stare at Mayuri with an uneasy lump in my throat.
ん？どうしたんだい？
あの、白羽さんもせかしてるのよ。遅れたら連帯責任だわ。
Ah, so that's it. How did I not notice it before?
ベッド。
ああ、遅れた私が悪いんだから、ベッドは真ん中でいいよ。下は委員長が取ったようだしね。
That's right. Up until now, I've been so nervous that I hadn't noticed, but...
この部屋、三人部屋だわ。
So you finally figured it out.
小坂さんも同室なの？
ひどいなあ。私だけ小公女みたいな生活をしろっていうのかい？
屋根裏部屋？このドミトリーってあったかしら？
冗談だよ。
Me too, says Rika's distant voice.
え？それじゃ、嘘か。本当に？
Yep, you're gonna be living with two girls! Get over it, Suo!I recall the quote from the Shawshank Redemption once again, then sit on the floor in confusion.
その様子じゃ、もしかして。
白羽さん？高坂さんが何かしたの？違うの。あの、変な質問かもしれないけど。
I take another breath.
高坂さんも、この部屋で共同生活をするの？
I ask.
そうか。なるほどね。
The two of them look more astonished than anything by my question. But...
でも、アミティエは花火師さんでしょ？共同生活の相手はアミティエだけだって。これって、も…
ああ、なんでかはわからないけど、行き違いか話を聞いてなかったみたいだね。
話？
Could be. I think back to the Amitya selection at the lecture hall. The teacher in charge of the selection committee said Rika Hanabishi was my Amitya partner.
あのね、白羽さん。何か思い違いをしているようだけど、アミティエは三人一組なのよ。
は？
選考で名前が呼ばれてから最後、今年から二人組のアミティエよりも。三人組でのアミティエの方がコミュニティ能力が上がるだろうからそうなったって話したじゃないか。
Ah! That's interesting. I got stuck on the word partner and became two people.
報道で選考委員の方からリッカさんの名前が出たとき。
The very name I had hoped for.
緊張から聞き逃してしまったのね、きっと。
それか、よほど花火師さんの名前が出て喜んだから、私の名前は耳に入らなかったと。
Her guess is right on the mark, and I blush and look down. Mayuri smiles surreptitiously, while Rika's white skin turns redder and redder.
Mayuri さんも、アミティエに。
First I get to partners with Rika, and now with Mayuri! This is wonderful! But... While it's true that I am happy that she is my Amitya partner, it is not quite as Mayuri says. The partner I'll live with from here on out. It could get awkward. I've got to resolve our misunderstandings.
あれ、黙ったままなんて、本当に図星だったのかな？
あのね、白羽さんは落ち着いた大人の女性なんです。呆れているのよ。
I hear the words over my head as I stare at my nails, trying to escape reality. I then notice my handkerchief has fallen to the floor and go to pick it up.
聞き取れない。 しら。
That is what Rika had said. I wiped the sweat that is beaded on my forehead with the handkerchief in my hand.
ん？何をいきなり笑っているのよ。
いや、まさかひょうたんからコマだと思ってさ。
What an old saying, she says, and looks again to where Mayuri is pointing. When she turns her eyes to me, she suddenly freezes.
Shirahane-san, それ…
Whoa! Wait! That is not a handkerchief! That is not a handkerchief!
Her red skin turns even redder as she points.
Those are pantsu!
My handkerchief. It's, well…
ごめんなさい。返してもらえるかしら?
The thing in my hand turns out to be what Rika had been holding on her bed.
初日から飛ばすね、白羽さん。
Oopsie! I can hear her chuckling. I stand there clutching her panties, wondering what I should do. My brain frozen like my body, I look up to the indigo evening sky peeking in through the window.
Oh! 私が
彼女の演奏し、I think of a queen.
思い出すのは、王女という単語。取り返しがつか
ない。 A beautiful queen, spoiled beyond repair.
美しい王女。確かな子を持ち。
Proud and aloof.
相手の心を。
With no qualms about hurting the feelings of others.
絶対的な。
But as I watch him march those girls into the gallows. 彼女らを見ても。
精神的虐殺。
And play their hearts into playrooms.I cannot help but feel that she is waiting for her turn to come. This is the story of my encounter with the queen. I think this means. Oh, I'm right. I'm so right. Well, we're gonna get started with chapter 2 in the next episode. Thank you for watching. Be sure to leave a like. And see ya in the next one.